Hello students, welcome back to the class. Last classes we have discussed about. In this class we are going forward for the power and different kinds of power. Okay, so we'll go forward. In this class we are mainly concentrating on the power and what are the different types of power, and this is a quite new concept. Okay, we are going forward. In the last class students, we have dealt with the joystick. We have discussed the various types of joysticks: economic joystick, social joystick, political joystick. Okay, now in this class mainly we are concentrating upon the power and what are the different types of power. Okay, this is the point. Now I'll go forward here. Children's introduction point: if you see the concept of power is a very key concept which is covering all the aspects of political science. Okay, so the power covers all the aspects of political science. Just like that, in the last class we have discussed about joystick. That is also one of the important concept of political science. Before that last class we have discussed about the liberty. One common thing here we can find is the first thing. These are the important concepts of political science. Just like liberty, equality, joystick. Similarly, power, power is also one of the important concept of political science, which will cover all the aspects of political science. So power is covering all the aspects of political science. We'll go forward. So politics have viewed a process of resolutions of conflicts. Okay, in the politics we can find the resolution of conflicts. Now what is meant by resolution of conflicts? Resolution of conflicts means here, this is a way for two or more political parties to find a peaceful solution for the disagreement among themselves. Children, two parties are there. Two political parties, normally if they have a different issue, because of the different issue, if they wanted to solve the problems, these two political parties are finding a peaceful way. Resolution conflicts means whenever the two political parties were finding a peaceful way to decrease the differences in order to solve their problems. Whenever the two political parties are finding a peaceful way to solve the problems is called resolution conflicts. So this is a way so that in two or more political parties will find a peaceful solutions for the disagreement among themselves. So whatever the two political parties have disagreed, in order to remove the disagreement, they are going for the peaceful solutions for that. Okay, whenever the two political parties are forming a peaceful solutions in order to remove the disagreement among themselves is called as resolutions conflict. Okay, that is called as resolutions conflict. So what we have discussed, so nowadays we can find in the politics a process of resolution conflicts is common. Okay, resolution conflicts are nothing but whenever the two political parties, because of the different issue, because of the disagreement among themselves, these two political parties are finding a peaceful solutions for the differences is called resolution conflicts. Now here if you see the distribution of power, that power must be distributed in the political community so that the conflicts can be able to resolve. Okay, most of the powers must be distributed to the political communities to decrease the conflicts. Now what is meant by political community? Political communities are nothing but, for example, the government. Any person whose authority, everything is under the control of them, who are accountable to the people. Government is accountable to the people. Okay, so political community is government. Okay, similar to government, who is accountable to the people. So distribution of power, whatever the powers will be there, that will be among the political communities so that the conflicts must be resolved. Whatever the conflicts, whatever the problems, whatever the fights will be there, that should be resolved. Okay, next, power also influence. Every person should accept, willingness, acceptance, every person should accept it. Okay, power, it also influence, all the people should accept. Okay, when all the people are accepting, willingness, acceptance are very, very important in this point. Okay, power. So resolutions which are accepted, willingness, acceptance, so power also influence, every person should accept the point. Next, according to the meaning, when you are saying power is nothing but ability to get one's wishes carried out despite resistance. okay, if you are getting one wishes, even though they are resisting, that is called as power. So ability to get one wishes in spite of resistance. Resistance are nothing but refuse to accept. Even though the person is refused to accepting, but he is giving you the wishes. Power is nothing but ability to get a person. Power is nothing but ability to get one's wishes despite of resistance and all. That is one point. Next, there are various forms of power. The first important point we'll discuss about what is meant by political power. Okay. Political power, children, the powers which are in the politics, that is political powers, will greatly influence, and this were mainly exercised by formal as well as informal organs. In political powers, we can find in politics two important organs are greatly influenced. Okay, powers, political power is greatly influenced under formal as well as informal organs. Formal organs means what? Whatever the organs which are recognized by government. Organs which are recognized by government, that comes under formal. Whatever the organs which are not recognized, unrecognized organs are called as informal organs. So even in political powers are greatly influenced and exercised by formal as well as informal organs. Next we'll go forward. The powers which are in the politics, that is called as political power. Whoever the person have power in the politics, whatever the power which are there in the politics, that is called as political power. So government operates power. So government operates power in the form of power of states, power of government and power of law. By these three powers, the government operates power. So government will operate power, okay, such as power of state, power of government and power of law. Okay, these are the three important things. Formal organs already influence the formal organs were also influenced with informal organ. They were greatly affected by informal organ. Which organ? So formal organs were greatly influenced by informal organ, because nowadays informal organ, not only they are taking the political parties, but also they are forming in the opposition party, but also they are forming a mass media, they are forming a various public opinion, and they are taking place in the various popular movement, informal organs which are taking, and they are forming a pressure group. Pressure group, this is very important point. What is meant by pressure group? Children, pressure group, when we are talking here, a groups where the people work together to influence what other or even the government thinks about particular subject. So these pressure groups, they will try to influence other, they will try to influence the thinking of others, they try to influence the thinking of even government, whatever they are thinking about a particular subject, in order to achieve their thing. Okay, in order to achieve this thing, the informal organs, what they are doing, they are creating a pressure group. Pressure groups are nothing but these groups, what they are doing, pressure group, they are creating pressures. Okay, these groups mainly they are working so that they try to influence what other people thinks and what the government thinks about a particular subject. Okay, so that to try to influence, so they are trying to influence the others, they are trying to influence the government so that whatever the government and other people is thinking about any particular subject, they are trying to influence the thinking so that they can able to achieve their object. That is called as power pressure group. Once again I am explaining, pressure groups are nothing but, okay, pressure groups means a group of the people who try to influence the thinking of others, who will try to change, will try to affect the thinking of others or even government about any particular subject. For example, a particular subject is there. Other persons and what the government thinks about the particular subject. So these pressure groups, what they are doing, they are influencing, they are playing a very important role. They are influencing the role of other persons. Okay, what the other, they are influencing the, okay. So these are working together to influence the other peoples as well as government, what they thinks about particular subject. Why they are influencing the other peoples as well as government mind, so that they can able to achieve their object. That is called as pressure group. Okay, so these informal organs are in a various form, pressure groups. So this is nothing but these are the groups of the people. They will try to influence the thinking of others, they will try to influence the thinking of even government, what they thinks about the subject, what the other people and thinks government thinks about the subject, they try to change the mind so that they can able to achieve their object. Who? Informal organs. So informal organs are nothing but there are some group of people. These groups, what they are doing, they are trying to influence the mind of others. They try to influence the mind of even government, which what they think about particular subject. They are greatly influencing the thinking of others as well as government. So that why they are doing, why they are influencing the others as well as government about particular subject, so that this pressure group peoples can able to achieve their goal. Now this is one point. So formal organs, that's why most of the formal organs are greatly influenced by informal organs. Why? Because these informal organs are creating a pressure groups and they are creating great influence upon the mind of formal organs. Okay, so informal organs, what they are doing, these are the informal organs, are the group of people, they are influencing the other groups as well as government about the particular subject so that they can able to achieve their goal. Now comprehensive means dealing with all. Comprehensive analysis of power is going behind the formal organs to informal organs also. Whatever the analysis of power, comprehensive analysis of power is going behind to formal organs as well as informal organ. So this is called as political power. Sometimes the political power, party powers plays very important role. So once again we'll go forward. So children, in the last class we have discussed about, okay, justice we have discussed. What are the various types of justice? In this class we are discussing about the power. Okay, introduction, I already said power is a very important concept in the political science. Okay, in the concept of political science, the key concept, okay, power is a very important concept and key concept which covers all the aspects of political science, which is covering all, from power is covering all the important aspects of political science. Politics, in politics we can view the process of resolution conflicts. In political areas we can see the process of resolution conflicts. What I have explained to you, what is meant by resolution conflicts? Resolution conflicts are nothing but when this is a way in which two or more person, they find two or more parties, they find a peaceful solutions for the disagreement among themselves. For example, two parties are there, they want these two parties are finding a peaceful solutions. Okay, these two parties have disagreement among themselves. So in order to be peaceful, these two parties, what they are doing, they are forming a peaceful solutions for the disagreement among themselves. So that is called as what, resolution of conflicts. So nowadays in the political parties we can find resolution of conflicts are common. Okay, no political parties wanted any conflicts. So these two political parties, even though if they have a different issue, they are coming together peacefully and peacefully and friendly, they are solving the problems. So whatever the disagreements were there previously, so these disagreements were converted into agreements by talking in a peaceful way. So that is called as resolution of conflicts. Distribution of power is taking place in the political communities so that the conflict should be resolved. Okay, whatever the conflicts are there, that will be resolved whenever the distribution of power is taking place in the political communities. So every person have power greatly influence the willingness, acceptance for all. So all the people should accept willing. Okay, willingness, acceptance should, must be done by all. Now H.B. wise man, what he said, that power is nothing but ability to get one's wish despite of resistance. Resistance are nothing but reject and not accept, that is called resistance. So H.B. wise man, what is saying, that power is nothing but ability to get one's wish despite of resistance, that is called as definition of power. Now next come to, we have various types of power. First one is called as political power. Political powers are greatly influenced by the formal as well as informal organs. So political parties are greatly influenced by both the organs. Political parties are influenced by formal organ, but mainly the political parties are greatly influenced by informal organs too. So here power in the politics is called as political power. Whatever the power which are there in politics, anybody who have power in the politics, he can say that he has a political power. Government operates different types of power, such as power of state. Okay, state government, power of state, power of government, power of law, etc. Nowadays formal organs, I have explained to you, the organs which are mainly recognized by the government, that is formal. Any organs which are not recognized, that comes under the informal organs. Okay, so here we can find there are two organs, formal as well as informal organs. Formal organs means which are following which are
recognized by government and which are following perfect rules and regulations. Okay, now come to the point. Formal organs are greatly influenced by informal organs, because these informal organs, they are not only forming the political parties, but also there are forming the opposition party. Already we know country, we have two party, ruling party, opposition party. So these informal organs are not only creating a party, opposition party, they are creating a mass media, large amount of media. Mass media means like newspaper comes under mass media. It will communicate a large section of people. Okay, internet is a mass media, TV, radio, newspaper, all these things comes under mass media. Why? Mass media is nothing but in one stage you are communicating with large number of people. Whenever if you are communicating, you can able to communicate with, or we can send a message to a large number of people, that is mass media or information. So these informal organs are creating a mass media. They are taking a form of various political parties, and sometime opposition party, and sometime pressure group. Pressure group is a very important thing. What is meant by pressure group is nothing but, we'll go forward. This is a type of group. Okay, a group where the people are working together. These groups will work together. Why? So these groups will work together to influence what other people or government thinks about particular subject. They will influence the mind. So these groups mainly works upon the, these groups will mainly works upon the particular thing. So what for these groups, what they are doing, they are working together. Okay, pressure groups means in there are some informal organs which act as a pressure group. In informal organs, some groups are working together to influence the mind of other people as well as government about any particular subject, so that they can able to achieve their goal. Informal organs, they can able to achieve the goal. This is one point. Next, here this is very very comprehensive analysis are very important. Comprehensive analysis are very important, and here there are certain powers which are going behind formal as well as informal organs. Okay, this is one point. So children, in this class we have discussed about the powers and the various kinds of power. In the next class we'll discuss about what is the second point of power. Okay, we will meet you in the next class with the same topic. Thank you very much, everybody.